a small business owner. He operates Abraham's Electric here in Elizabeth City. Mr. Saunders is proud to be a lifelong learner. He began GED classes in the evenings in 1973, and he graduated in 1976. He was a diligent student, all while working full-time, and in the meanwhile, he was blessed with twins. Mr. Saunders did not stop. As he continued his education at Old Dominion and received an electrical certificate, and then earned his electrical license. The lifelong learning that he does, Mr. Saunders is continuously enrolling in continuing education classes to update his electrical knowledge and skills. Mr. Saunders is active in the community and serves as a deacon at Mount Zion Church. I present to you your commencement speaker, Mr. Randy Saunders.
This speech tonight is geared towards setting attainable goals and have a backup plan. Life has a way of happening. I would like first to congratulate the students that made it. Second, I would like the faculty and staff to thank the faculty and staff for allowing me to stand before you today. Thirdly, I would like to thank the family and the friends who encouraged, supported, and pushed these graduates to complete this program. Without their support, some of you wouldn't be here. Today, my task is simple. I'm here to give you a few words of encouragement with a hint of wisdom and a splash of personal experiences. I am living proof these programs are vital in our community and society. People ask me about my school. I tell them that I did it the hard way. What I mean by that is, I earned the right to sit with you graduates and sitting. I had two kids, a wife, 2 years of night school, just to get where you are today. So I applaud you, and I want to say, keeping on with the good work that you're doing. At this moment, you are closing one chapter in a book. Whether you want this book to be a short book or you want it to be a full novel, that's up to you. This is only the beginning. As you climb the rounds of success, life is going to be just that much better. Whether you like it or not, life is bound to happen. While working in the shipyard, I was in a terrible accident which caused me to change my plans. I started off working in the shipyard without a high school diploma. My parents didn't graduate from high school, so it was only ever that I graduated from high school. I cleaned septic tanks and did other remedial passions that it was given to me to do because I didn't have an education. That was the catalyst that would drive me to go back to school and earn the 2 earnings evening and move further on. I would ask you all, I would challenge you all, just don't stop here. Life is even better if you continue to climb an educational ladder. College of Albemarle has a wide variety of programs that you can choose from health science, business, industrial technology, or just a few paths that you can take. Your next chapter can start right here. If you remember anything that I say, remember this simple equation. Experience plus education equals good path. You are on the right track. Keep pushing forward. Money plays a big role in today's life. Money controls what you eat. Money controls where you live, even what you drive. So, why not take this opportunity to continue your education? That formula is, the more education, the more money you make. If you don't put forth any hard work and dedication, you'll reap what you sow. Your lifestyle will be equal to little education, little lifestyle. I took every class that was offered to me at Newport News Shipyard, even took classes as I continued at Elizabeth City State, any kind of professional development in my field. I'm now 61 years old and I'm still doing the education thing. I recently took up a class in astronomy, just to broaden my horizons and keep moving forward. I urge you to take your own situations as to fuel, to motivate, and to continue your education. In conclusion, just remember, keep moving. Plans change. Always have a plan B. Thank you for allowing me to share my story with you. Keep striving for greatness and close chapters one by one. Again, congratulations.
Let's give him another round of applause.